गुड मॉर्निंग प्रीति ठक्कर बैक टू यू विद एसएस स्टैंडर्ड 7
चैप्टर 4 मुगल एम्पायर एस्टैब्लिशमेंट एंड एक्सटेंशन. इंडिपेंडेंस डे वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन 15th ऑफ ऑगस्ट. प्रतीक सॉ द नेशनल फ्लैग बीइंग अनफर्ल्ड एट द रेड फोर्ट ऑन हिज टीवी एट होम. He even saw different pictures of Red Fort. The next day, Prateek asked his class teacher all about the Red Fort. His teacher downloaded pictures of Red Fort as well as pictures of other architectural monuments from the internet and showed them to the students. While showing them the pictures, the teachers told them that those monuments were constructed during the Mughal period. She decided to tell them all about Mughal rule. So here you all know that we all celebrate Independence Day on 15th August. And here Prateek saw the pictures and asked all about it to the teacher. And teacher is showing the pictures about and telling them all about the Mughal period and the Mughal rule. Delhi was under Ibrahim Lodi's rule during that time, and Babur ruled in Kabul, Afghanistan. Babur was the ruler of Mughal dynasty. He attacked Delhi in 1526 CE. Ibrahim Lodi was defeated by Babur's well-equipped army, which had cannons, in the Battle of Panipat. This brought an end to Sultanate age and the establishment of Mughal rule. In the beginning, the Mughals ruled near Delhi. Babur won many battles and his descendants gradually extended the empire. Let's learn about the incident that occurred during Mughal age and know more about the administration and social life of that time. See children, here it is said about Ibrahim Lodi. He was the last ruler of Lodi dynasty in India. This period was also known as Sultanate age. Lodi ruled from Delhi. At that time, Babur ruled over Kabul in Afghanistan. He was the ruler of Mughal dynasty. To establish his rule in India, he attacked Delhi in 1526 CE. Then Ibrahim Lodi was defeated in this battle of Panipat. This brought an end to Sultanate age in India. Babur became the first ruler of Mughal dynasty in India. Mughals ruled from Delhi. They won many battles and expanded their empire in India. Now, main events of Mughal dynasty. First of all, Babur, that is in 1526 to 1530. In 1527 CE, he fought a battle with the brave Rana Sangha at Kanwa, in which Babur defeated him and his army was equipped with cannons. In 1530, Babur fell ill and died. He fought many battles to lay a strong foundation of Mughal Empire and gain control over areas near Delhi and Agra. He emerged victorious in most of the battle. See, here it is said that Babur was the founder of Mughal dynasty in India. He attacked Delhi in 1526 and established Mughal rule in India by winning the battles of Panipat. Then in 1527 CE, he fought a battle with brave Rana Sangha at Kanwa. Babur used cannons in the war and defeated him. He fought many battles and laid a very strong foundation of Mughal empire in Delhi. And then Delhi and Agra also. He mostly won all the battles. In 1530, he fell ill and died. We are going to learn about Humayun. See children, in 5th standard, we have already learned more about Babur, Humayun, Akbar, etc. And we are still going to learn forward here. Humayun, in 1530 to 1540 and 1555 to 1556, Humayun ascended the throne of Delhi after Babur. According to his father's will, the kingdom was divided and each of his brothers inherited one province. He retained Delhi. Humayun had to struggle a lot against his brother Kamran and the Afghans. Humayun was defeated twice by Sher Shah, and he had to escape for 15 years in order to save his life. During that time, Akbar was born in the palace of King of Amarkot. Humayun regained Delhi from the successor of Sher Shah. Now here, children, it is said that Humayun was Babur's son, as we have already learned in fifth. He ascended the throne after Babur. As per Babur's will, the kingdom of Mughal dynasty was divided among his sons. Then Humayun followed Babur's will and divided the kingdom among his brothers. Humayun ruled over Delhi. Then Humayun had constantly to struggle with his brother Kamran and even the Afghan invaders. Humayun lost twice against Afghan invader Sher Shah. Hence, Humayun escaped and remained hidden for 15 years. Meanwhile, what happened? Humayun's wife gave birth to Akbar in the palace of the king of Amarkot. Later, Humayun regained Delhi from the rulers that ruled after Sher Shah. Then, we are going to learn who is this Sher Shah and how he came to rule over. Sher Shah, he ruled in 1540 to 1545. Sher Shah Suri was an Afghan leader who had progressed in his own. He defeated Humayun twice and therefore established the Sur dynasty in Delhi. After gaining control over Delhi, he won many other important battles. He then extended his empire from Kabul to Bengal at Malwa. He is known as a reformer in history. After Sher Shah, the Mughal dynasty was re-established in Delhi. See, children, here again, we have already heard the name Sher Shah in first term's chapter. Sher Shah Suri was an Afghan leader and he progressed on his own. He defeated Humayun two times and then established Suri dynasty in Delhi. After establishing his rule over Delhi, he won many other battles. He extended his empire from Kabul to Bengal and Malwa. He ruled over for 5 years. He also was known as a famous reformer in history. After Sher Shah, Humayun again came back and re-established Mughal dynasty in Delhi. Now, we are going to learn about Akbar. Akbar, 1556 to 1605. Akbar was just 13 years old when his father Humayun passed away. This story we have already learned in 5th standard about Akbar. He was very young, and so Bairam Khan, the faithful minister of Humayun, brought him up as a guardian and took care of administration on Akbar's behalf. Hemu, the leader of Sikandar Sur, established his rule over Delhi when Akbar was in Punjab. With the guidance of Bairam Khan, Akbar defeated Hemu in the Battle of Panipat. Since Bairam Khan became more independent, Akbar seized away all his powers and sent him to Hajj. He was killed on the way to Hajj. Akbar annexed Chittor and Ranthambore in the battle against Rana Pratap. Frequent battles were fought between them. Akbar's empire expanded during the period between 1585-605 CE. He annexed Kandahar, Kashmir and Kabul and established his rule over Khandesh, Ahmednagar in south. There was a lot of disorder during this last days of Akbar's rule as Prince Salim revolted. Later on, Salim adopted the name Jahangir and ascended the throne. Now, children, here it is said that Akbar was the son of Humayun. When Humayun passed away, Akbar was only 13. Akbar ascended the throne at very small age. Hence, Bairam Khan, he was a loyal minister of Humayun, brought up Akbar as a guardian and also took care of the administration on his behalf. When Akbar was in Punjab, Hemu, the leader of Sukandar Suri of Sur dynasty, established his rule over Delhi. And however, under the guidance of Bairam Khan, Akbar defeated Hemu in the Battle of Panipat also. Bairam Khan was very faithful and he was becoming more independent than Akbar. Hence, Akbar snatched away all his rights and sent him to Hajj. He got killed on the way of Hajj. Later, Akbar defeated Rana Pratap and Win Chittor and Ratanbor through several battles. Then Akbar's empire expanded even more between 1585 CE to 1605 AD. During this period, he captured Khandar, Kashmir and Kabul in north and Khandesh in the Ahmednagar in south. In the last days of Akbar, his son Salim revolted against him. Hence, there was a chaos in the administration and so Salim took over Akbar's throne. Later, Salim adopted a new name, Jahangir, and ascended the throne of Mughal dynasty. And we have already gathered a lot of information about the different rulers of Mughal dynasty like Babur, Humayun, Akbar and Sher Suri of the Sur dynasty. Now on the basis of this, let us know about the administration, society, art and architecture forward. Now, we are going to... When Humayun had escaped, even the Hindu rulers gave him shelter. Therefore, their culture and reflected in upbringing of Akbar. He took the help of Hindu rulers when he ascended the throne. He knew that he would not be able to rule India if he ignored the Rajput rulers. Therefore, he maintained good relation with the Rajput rulers and won their confidence. The rulers who did not accept his authority had to face him. The rulers of Sisodia Rajputs did not accept him or accept his rule and made many confrontations with him. See children, here it is said that when Sher Shah defeated Humayun, he escaped from Delhi and then Hindu rulers gave shelter to Humayun. Influence of the contact with Hindu rulers could be seen in upbringing of Akbar. Akbar was born when Humayun was in the palace of Hindu, king of Amarkot. Now, Humayun regained his throne of Delhi only because of Hindu rulers helped him. Humayun maintained very good relations with Rajput because he knew that without their support, he would not be able to rule India. However, those rulers who did not accept his supremacy had to face Humayun in battle. For example, rulers of Sisodia of Mewar did not accept Humayun's rule and so they had several conflicts with Humayun. Now, tradition of inheritance. The king was responsible for appointing the successor of the kingdom and it would usually be the oldest son. During the Mughal rule, all the sons would get an equal share of empire. This king of Hirasi was implemented during Humayun's reign. After that, rulers conspired against each other for the throne. Brothers would quarrel with one another for the throne and whoever won ascended the throne of Delhi. So here children, it was like they used to fight among themselves. Generally, the Mughal king used to appoint their successor as the kings. But then, normally, the eldest son was appointed as a successor. While all the sons used to get equal share in the empire, they fought for the throne. They used to fight for the throne. Whoever won used to ascend the throne for Delhi. Now, moving forward toward the administrative system. The Subedari system was implemented during the Mughal period. Akbar divided his kingdom into 15 sections. Each section was known as Suba or province. The subsections of Suba was called government and subsection of government was known as Pargana. The head of each Pargana was called Amir. who would collect the revenue. There were Gram Panchayat in village, and the head was known as Patel, Chaudhary, Mukadam, etc. Thus, during that time, various executes were appointed. So, children, here it is said that during Mughal dynasty, Subedari system was implemented. Akbar had divided his kingdom into 15 sections, and each section was known as Suba or province. Subsections were called government, and subsection of government was called Pargana. The head of Pargana was known as Amir, and Amirs used to collect taxes. Village were administrated by Gram Panchayat, and head of Gram Panchayat was called Patel, Chaudhary or Mukadam. In this way, Mughal appointed various executives for the administration of entire kingdom. Then, during Akbar's reign, pilgrim tax was not levied. Thus, there would be a huge crowds in the pilgrim center. Pilgrim means Jatra. Akbar was considered to be the most tolerant and benevolent king among all the Mughal rulers. He regularly organized religious meet in the prayer hall at Sikri. It was also called discussion hall, as religious matter were discussed there. Representatives from all the regions attended the meeting. The royal court was adorned by the scholars. See, children, here it is said that Akbar was the most liberal king among the Mughals. He removed the pilgrim tax, and the Hindu pilgrims had to pay. Then, due to this, number of pilgrims increased drastically. Then Akbar regularly attended the religious meet that was in the prayer hall at Sikri. And this prayer hall was also called discussion hall, because Akbar used to discuss religious matters there. Then, moreover, representatives of all regions used to attend these meetings. Owing to such considerate nature of Akbar towards religion, one can very well say that he was kind and liberal towards all the religions. The nine gems of Akbar's court were Todarmal, the revenue minister, Man Singh, the leader of Daksh army, Abul Fazal, the historian and writer of Anain Akbari and Akbarnama, Tansen, the famous singer, Mulla Do Piyaza, the clever and jolly courtier, Mahesh Das Birbal, the quick-witted courtier and trickster. He was a trickster. Trickster matlab cheater. Hamam, the famous Vaidya physician, Faizya, the renowned poet, and Abdul Rahim, the Hindi verse writer. See, children, here it is all given, the nine gems of Akbar court. Todarmal. Todarmal was the revenue minister. Then Man Singh, that was the leader of Daksh army. Then Abdul, the famous historian, right? And the writer of Aine Akbari and Akbarnama. Tansen, the famous singer. Mulla Dofia, the highly intelligent and jolly courtier. Then Mahesh Das Birbal, the trickster and quick-witted courtier. Vaidya Hamam, that was a famous Vaidya, that was physician. Faizi, the renowned poet, and Abdul Rahim, the Hindi verse writer. Now, reforms made by Sher Shah. Sher Shah ruled over Delhi for 5 years. He introduced many reforms during this short span, and is therefore better known as a reformer than a warrior. With Todarmal's help, he prepared a table for revenue collection based on the type of land and production. Akbar followed the same method for revenue collection. He removed the toll booths so that there could be free transportation of goods. He constructed roads to increase trade and for the convenience of pedestrians, among which the famous roads were constructed between Agra and Burhanpur, Agra and Meerwar, Lahore and Mulan. He also planted trees on both the sides of road and constructed rest houses. And he had step up mint houses to mint silver coins uniform in weight. He was very strict about the discipline of the army and had therefore strictly ordered the army not to harass the villagers or destroy crops while marching. During his reign, Kotwals were responsible for arresting criminals. Sher Shah was himself very active and motivated others too by keeping them busy at work. So here, children, it is said that Sher Shah Suri was an Afghan ruler who established a rule in Delhi, as we learned. He ruled over for 5 years and became quite famous as a great reformer. He was more famous as a reformer than a warrior. Then, with the help of Todarmal, he classified land on the basis of its type and productivity. Based on this classification, both of them prepared a table for collecting land revenue. When Akbar came into power, he also followed the same method of rent. Sher Shah removed octroi so that the trade and transport of goods could increase. He also constructed roads to increase the trade for the convenience of pedestrians. He constructed very famous roads between Agra to Burhanpur, Agra to Merwar, and Lahore to Munal during this reign. Trees were also planted on both the sides of road. Guest house and inns were constructed on the highway for the comfort of travelers. He established mint houses so that uniform silver coins could be produced. He was very strict about the discipline of army. He strictly ordered his army not to harass the villagers or to care about the army, did not destroy the crops while marching. Local police officers known as Kotwal were responsible for recording the crimes in their books during his rule. Sher Shah himself was very active and he always kept others also motivated by making them work hard. Now, towards Chittor's tales of bravery. There were frequent struggles between Mughals and Sisodia Rajputs. The courageous Sisodia Rajputs were not ready to accept Mughal supremacy and so fought against Akbar boldly and bravely. Among all the warriors, Maharana Pratap's bravery is specially noteworthy. Among the rulers of Sisodia dynasty, Maharana Pratap was one who fought against Akbar continuously till the end. Since Akbar wanted to set up his rule in Mewar, there were many battles fought between Mewar and Delhi, among which the Battle of Haldighat is considered to be a landmark battle. Akbar had a huge, well-equipped army with modern weapons and powder in sufficient numbers and artillery, whereas Maharana Pratap had the advantage of his chivalrous Rajput warriors who lived in the forest and were therefore used to fighting wars in hilly area. There were just 20 to 22,000 soldiers who fought bravely against lack of Mughal soldiers. So children, here it is said that Mewar was ruled by Sisodia Rajput, whereas Delhi by Mughals. Akbar wanted to capture Mewar, but Rajputs were not ready to accept them, right? And Akbar had well-equipped huge army of lakhs of soldiers. Akbar wanted to capture Mewar. Among Sisodia Rajput, Maharana Pratap fought till the end with Akbar. The Battle of Haldighat is considered to be the most important battle between Akbar and Maharana Pratap. Akbar was also well equipped with a huge army and they were also loaded with modern weapons, cannons and war tactics. On the other hand, Maharana Pratap had very small army, till 20 to 22,000 soldiers. However, the soldiers were very brave. Maharana Pratap's army had an advantage of fighting from hilly region. Also, the army was habituated to fight in the hilly region. Then, in the Battle of Haldighat, Maharana Pratap was and his horse Chetak attained martyrdom, and then that can never be forgotten. Chetak was specially trained for battles. In the battlefield, Chetak would move according to Maharana Pratap's command. When the battle of Haldigarh was at its peak, Chetak acted according to Rana Pratap's instructions and jumped high to reach up to the Mughal Senapati, who was seated on his elephant. A noteworthy incident is one where Rana Pratap threw a spear at Senapati, but he was saved because of the howdah, that is the seat on the elephant's back, that is known as howdah. There were many such incidents in the Battle of Haldigarh, which were noteworthy. It is believed that when Maharana Pratap was injured, one of his leaders wore his canopy to distract the Mughal rulers. That is, wore his canopy, matlab wearing his cap like headwear. Headwear matlab uska jo throne hota hai, upar ka mukut hota hai wo. Chetak took the injured Rana Pratap away from the battlefield. There were many such incidents about Rana Pratap in history. Maharana Pratap lost the battle against Akbar but did not give up. He wandered in the forest, faced many difficulties, but remained determined. Rana Pratap formed the army again when he helped Bhama Shah, a Jain trader who helped him financially, and fought against the Mughals again. He won all the forts except Chittor. He vowed, "Till I get back Chittor, I will not sleep peacefully." So here it is said that the Battle of Haldigarh was fought between Akbar and Maharana Pratap. Akbar had the army, lakhs of soldiers were loaded, and as I said, they had modern weapons and cannons. And here it is said that Maharana Pratap had highly trained a horse named Chetak. And Chetak was so trained that he moved anywhere as per Pratap's will. When the battle was at its peak, Maharana Pratap ordered Chetak to jump as high as back of elephant, on which Senapati of Akbar army was seated. When Chetak jumped, Maharana Pratap hit the Senapati with a spear, but he was saved due to the howdah. Howdah means, as I said, the seat on the elephant. The Battle of Haldigarh witnessed many such brave incidents of Maharana Pratap. He believed that when he was injured, one of his soldiers wore the crown of Maharana Pratap to fool the Mughals. Meanwhile, Chetak took Pratap away from the battlefield to save his life. And then Maharana Pratap lost this Battle of Haldigarh, and with the help of Jain trader Bhama Shah, who helped him financially, Rana Pratap again formed the army. He again fought with the Mughals. He won back all the forts except the Chittor, but he vowed, matlab he promised himself, "Till I get back Chittor, I will not sleep on bed." He kept his vow till the end, and he was very brave and untiring. So he was known as the steadfast quality. Here I end the chapter, and bye. See you then with the next chapter.